and because of the dart we were intercepting basically in the middle, which is perfect, I'll press approach, and that will take over the vertical speed as well to follow the glide slope as well as the arm nav. I'll just minimise it so we can see, and I'll put the power up here. And that's going to be flaps 10. I'll put that to 185. So we're intercepting at 12 nautical miles, almost just ahead of us. There we are. So we've got a visual on the runway, and there's no traffic on final. But I can see perhaps one here, but that's very near the runway. So because glide slope's active, I can now set the altitude to be 7,000. I think that's what it was for the missed approach. 7,000. 2,500 and gear down. But either way, after takeoff it's out to Zurich and then out to Amici, and I guess it would just be a hold at Amici. So I could quickly show you that. Very simply, I just put Amici as the hold, and we'll put the inbound course as the runway heading, basically 135, with a left turn, keep it away from the airport, and execute that, very simply. Okay, here comes the wind. I'm going to go over to manual throttle and rearm it if we have to go around, and start to bring the speed back now for the flaps at 1000 over to manual, roll out flare, and the runway heading is set on the heading
1000
I don't need to modify the the indicated airspeed because the go-around procedure automatically sets the speed for me, depending on when I retract the flaps. It's basically 1,000. You can see that we're still going over terrain, so we're not exactly 1,000. We've got a wind, tailwind at 8 knots, it's very useful. The wind's going to be throwing us around a bit there. One of the windiest landings I've had to do. It's 500.
400. 300.
I'm just staying below the reference speed because of the tailwind. I don't want to float down the runway too much. Okay, we're floating too much, going around.
Don't sink.
So that's TOGA. Gear up and flaps to 20. And we're maintaining runway heading of 136. 136 now. go through flaps 10, you can see that the speed has gone up to 196 from 175. We're just approaching runway 5 nautical miles shortly. And then we'll start our left turn to Zurich. Now with VNAV giving us 250, and it's going to follow now the legs in the page here. And if you get off, that's to one. Traffic off to the left, 400 above, 500, 600. A bit too close to comfort, but climbing traffic could be worse. So out to Zurich and then out to Amici on the VOR here. And level 7,000. Just the brakes to off so we can redo the approach check next to not forget anything, miss anything, or assume we've done something. So back onto the area controller, into the hold at M key. We'll probably go around once and then we might be given. I'd prefer to take a new runway heading actually because that had a tailwind and I was floating down the runway. Free for the turn, and I'm quite happy that happened because I can now show you what happens on the hold page. So you can see on the legs page we're into Zurich, which is where we're just passing now, into Amici, and it will hold at Amici. So just watch. Now this is a target speed 257,000, that's what's set here. I can modify that if I want to. I don't want to, it's okay. Further ahead below us, 3,000. That's okay. And the inbound leg is 135, I believe that's set, 135. There's an aircraft ahead of us descending, active route hold. So the first turn is the entering the whole turn. It won't actually do a right turn and follow the anarchy route round to the left. It's entering the hold now, so it's going to do a 360. So it can intercept the inbound leg of 135. So it's just coming this way. It's going to pick up the track and it's going to start going around like this. It doesn't fly into the hold and do that. Otherwise it will have to do a big right and a big left and it will become horrible. So we've entered the hold. Normally it's a little cool, but we've entered the hold. If I press V now, that should maintain 250, 7000 as per the next range. So we're in the hold on V now and on. Now 250 is a bit too fast for a hold, it should be 230. Don't have to worry about that at the moment. So we're on the outbound leg, 315, inbound leg being 135. So this is still considered. Could still consider this an intercept course because we haven't yet actually come into the VOR, probably on the inbound leg of 135. We're about to do that now. Once we come across here, that's technically when we can say that we are in the hold on our first orbit. Increases because we're turning, because drag is increased, hence the power to increase. Hold 250 knots. So 7,000 is probably 5,000 ground level, above ground level. So as we're going around, I'm going to select a new runway. I didn't like first one because of the tailwind that we had, so we're going to select another direction. We'll take runway 34, ILS 34, which starts here. If we have to do a missed approach, then we'll be holding out at Gipol, which is part of our standard arrival earlier. So I'll execute this. We could select a missed approach path here, but I'll win. Good, so the approach is set up. We're still in the hold. And when I'm ready, we can exit the hold. We'll go at 150 knots on the approach speed now. 151, so we've burnt a bit of fuel. So we'll be leaving the hold, I think. We can leave the hold this time, we don't waste too much time going around here. On an intercept, we'll make it 190. Let the aircraft stabilise. Our exit is armed. And we'll be flying to Utixo, but I'll be flying with manual heading. We don't need to connect the two together. So we're still in the hold. Exit is armed, so on exiting the hold it won't turn again. I'll press heading select, that'll take us around to the right, heading 190 degrees. And the intercept altitude for this is 6,000, so I'll set 6,000. I will go to vertical speed, so I'm holding the speed and altitude, but LNAV is still following the VOR, the hold.